Hello everyone and welcome back to part 68 of our EA Sports WRC Let's Play. Yes, we return today here with a beautiful snowy rally Sweden. Of course, if you missed out on the Monte Carlo rally that went live yesterday, I would highly recommend going back and checking out. But I want to get back into the game and hopefully we can try and continue on scoring some points there. Seb Ogier took the win to kickstart the season ahead of Kali Rovanpera and Elvin Evans. But yeah, 7th place for us, just 1 point behind my teammate Hoffman. Hopefully, Sweden should be a really, really good rally for us. It's often one of the AI's weaker ones over the course of a championship, but I'm very well aware by saying that I have just jinxed myself, so fingers crossed we can keep it clean and tidy today. Try and score some good points on the board as well. Of course, if you're new around here, please do make sure to leave a like, get yourself subscribed. We're trying to hit 3k subs at the moment, and yeah, let's do this thing. Before we get into that though, I just want to thank today's video sponsor, IMB Racewear. I get asked all the time why I use gloves for sim racing, and truth be told, it saves you a lot of money in the long run. Yes, when you are using expensive steering wheels, it is really important that you have a pair of gloves that can protect the wheel from your oily, sweaty hands. And IMB Racewear have got some of the best gloves on the market. Of course, you can have the custom branded Matt212 gloves or any other gloves off of their site. There'll be a link down in the description below. And if you use that, you massively help support the channel at no extra cost to yourself.
Hello, I'm Molly Pettit, and welcome to round two of the FIA World Rally Championship. It's that time of year where the crews converge on the city of Umeå, ready to take on Rally Sweden. Preparations are underway as studded tyres are equipped and the crews familiarise themselves with the shovels they'll hope not to use. I don't think any one team can be fully confident of their strategy going into this event as conditions look to be unstable. If we have a look at the standings now, we can see that following on from some very impressive form, our top three championship spots are Ogier, Rovanpera and Evans. It's sure to be an exciting event here, and who knows what the standings will look like at the end of some thrilling action.
Well, here we are then, of course, back in Sweden. Obviously, I believe, if I remember correctly, stage 1 and 5 are the same. But it looks like we're going to see a bit of snow later on in the rally. No really long stages, though. I mean, you consider how high speed most of this rally is as well. That's always quite a surprise that we don't have one of the 20-kilometer runs or something like that. We will have two spare sets of the snow tyres. So a bit like Monte Carlo, not a lot of strategy. Simply just taking tyres at every service. And of course, as always, we'll dive in with our shakedown first of all. I believe after this rally, we've actually got the first round of the like modern rally car tour, which is like the late 90s to the mid. Oh, sorry, I think it's 1997 to 2011. I want to say, so that'll be really, really good fun as well. Obviously, to dive in and actually do a different rally event series type thing, which we haven't done since our WRC2 days, our first season of the WRC2, I believe, because obviously we had 2 years of regularity rallies alongside our official FIA campaign. So yeah, hopefully this season, obviously, we can have a bit of fun with some of those other events, because at the end of the day, I still want to drive some other cars on this game, and that's a really, really good way to do it as well there. But shakedown done and dusted then, everything as we would expect. Always got to be careful of that corner after the first sector. But yeah, that's all good then. So yeah, the key today, first couple of stages, just stay out of trouble. And after that, we'll kind of weigh up where we are. Of course, Rovanpera stacked it here last year. They get ready to put themselves and their car to the test on the first stage of the rally. Well, again then, Rovanpera fastest in stage one provisionally. See, we're going to be the 7th car out there, but I don't believe, maybe Craig Green, I think he beat me last time though, didn't he? He can often be quite a demon on the snow. 4, 3, 2, 1. Go 40, 5. Let's do this thing then. So we know where we're going on this first split. I mean, we should know where we're going everywhere on this rally. Let's keep it out of the snow drifts. That's going to be the other big thing today. You've got to try and keep it in the middle of the road. 6 right.
right, I'm going a little bit slower on this first split than I did on our shakedown run. But I'm not going to lose sleep over that, as long as we keep it out of trouble. Say this, like I said, because this rally is so high speed, it really should suit us. Then when you get those big slides, but you keep it straight and narrow in the end. Whether it was by luck or skill, you decide, but I'm just happy it is where I want it to be. A little bit scrappy then in this first bit. Still 4 tenths up though, which is good. We get this horrible corner straight after the first split. It'd be nice to practice that in the shakedown, but of course, it's not how it works, sadly. Always do that. Won't be the only time that happens over the course of this event as well, but the important thing is just gather it up. Don't lose time, don't get too much damage, get going. Short of the crest, and four left, overs and tightens. A bit ragged early on. Into five right, half long, over bumps, 40. Oh, come on. We've got to keep it tidier than this. Six left, break, 60. Two right sharp, at junction, and crest. Into five left, 80. Six right, don't cut, and two left, 110. Four right short, 50, five left, into crest, 70. Three right, and left of the crest, and slide right.
Just a little bit of time there. So fine margins between everyone though. 2 seconds is enough to drop us to 6th place, so we can't afford to let off the accelerator. Gotta get on with it. Or do that, of course. It's the first people I've ran over this year. It was always going to happen at some point, but that is a shame. Let's just try and see how far away we are then at the end of this first stage. This should be a really good one for us. No idea what I hit there, but it was solid. If we can sort of be within 10-15 seconds at the end of this first stage, I think I'll end up being quite happy with it. Really disappointed how sloppy this has ended up being, but we've got to get to the end. We've got to start trying to recover time. Still not a million miles away from everyone else, to be fair, but yeah, we do want to be fighting for a championship. Of course, we've won every other WRC crown in our second season. Convinced that'll happen while in the WRC. Just completely forgot that's where that jump was as well. Two hands on the wheel. 30, slight right, opens, 40, into crest, 80. Four left, tightens, two, around bales, into right of the crest, 40. Bump. Six right of the crest, extra long, keep in. Even try and claw back a little bit of time in this final four split. Left, keep give in, me a bit 40, of confidence to go into the next right, couple of stages. Opens. Almost at the finish line though. 30. Titans and bridge, 30, turn, square right, 40, 5 left, over the Ferro's gone through final corner though. Yeah, really not happy with the mess I've had through there, but we did take a second out of him again in that final sector, so we have definitely got pace, which is good to know for the rest of the rally. But yeah, first stage done and dusted then, 4:28, and only good enough for P9 there, 10th clear of Thierry Neuville. As always, Seb Ogier right on the money, and as I also said, Craig Breton right up at the front as well. They're 0.04 of a second quicker than Lappy, but yeah, 14 seconds back then by the end of stage one. We've got to get better than this. Right, stage two then, here we go. I believe this is the really, really fast run early on, where you basically flat throughout the entire first split. Let's see what we can do here though. You want to try and close in. That's not going to help, though. Oh, this is a really fast bit of road, so that's going to cost me loads.
But yeah, we need to try and go quicker than Robin Perra then if we want to match Breeny and Lappy here. But that's not going to help me out. Luckily, we're back to VMAX, although VMAX in these Hyundai seems to be a bit lower than every other car. Even the WRC2 cars, which isn't ideal. But how brave are we by the time we get to the end of this? 4 seconds back. But yeah, it's still pretty fast.
Right of a small jump, 80.
Can't really see where the road is, can you? Slowing. It is impossible.
Six right to the crest, long and turn square left. Don't cut into six right, 30.
Ooh, oh, there it is. Whoa. That was very Dakar-esque. Jump throw 50. It at the gully.
Left of a crest, into four left, very long tightens.
That's the other thing we've got to be careful of on this stage is all the little trees. I don't know what the trees are made of in Sweden, but even their shrubs are somehow able to withstand the full force of a rally car. Oh, that is lethal as well. Those are horrible. There's not many of them, but they will write off a car instantly. And I've certainly hit my fair share of them.
50,
slight left. It's good. Right, so well, let's see what the gap right, is for Robin Perra. 4 seconds still. It went the right way, though. That's reassuring. Should be better, though. Yeah, 2 amps on the wheel more. Definitely the mistake I made through stage one. These cars will try and go loose and lively on you. Oh, we got lucky there. The gully worked with me. Or the bank, sorry, even I should say. Oh no! Come on, normally it's if you go past the pole rather than through it. That's a shame. Gives us a bit more work to do though. I do hate it here how there is seemingly no room for error with those poles. And that tree apparently. Right next to the stage. Because inevitably you'll have made a mistake to end up framed of it anyway. Because that is close. We are risking it all early on here apparently. Yeah, we lost time anyway through that split, but that gap up to 10 is not fun.
Crest, 90.
Come on.
5 left short, 100. 5 right short, don't cut, and crest, slowing, 70.
So those thick right bits of snow where the car tries to turn on you as well. Because it basically just wants to tuck itself into a roll.
5 right, half long.
And they are not fun. 30. When you go full tumble dry mode on this game, I've done that a couple of times. Come on, we are losing time.
Into crest and four right, 80. Left of a jump, 150. Jump, 120. 5 left, tightens of a crest. Keep in 100. Slight right of a crest, very long. Don't cut, 50. Slight right to the crest, 80. Slowing, 6 right and late, 3 left, half long, tightens, 90.
I mean, how do you do this for a living now? Why? Like, you can tell why, you know, your fins and such are so good at this kind of thing. And obviously over there it's a bit more tarmac. Or sorry, gravel even, sorry, I should say. But you think, if you're having to drive on this kind of thing every day, of course your reactions are going to be good. Of course your understanding of a vehicle is going to be good. There we go, up towards the finish line though. Yeah, not more. We're going that way apparently. That's one way to finish the stage there, but yeah, the gap did pretty much level out towards the end of that stage, but 11 seconds back.
Through this stage, it looks like they've had a tough time and are going to lose their position in the event table.
Well, we're quicker than all the backmarkers, but slower than everyone else we'd actually want to be fighting with. Craig Breen again, top of the board. Quicker than Lappy. But yeah, we're losing out just little bits of time here and there, and already the gap 30 seconds back. We're going to need a big fight in these final few stages. Right, come on then. I believe this is the Gassen reversed. So we've really got to try and prove ourselves on this run the other way. Got the car all fully repaired and everything like that. So, yeah, hopefully. Oh, that's not a good way to start. So yeah, hopefully, of course, we're going to be able to show some good pace. Not going to hold me breath, though, because so far this rally, yeah, has been a little bit of a disaster. Oh, come on, get off the gilly, get off the gilly. Or the bank, even, I should say. Just, you have to keep this car in the middle of the stage. You know, the road might be X amount wide, but you've got a lot less to play with.
Big jump, 110. Four left of the crest, opens, 40. Six right, half long. Opens, into small crest, 130. Five right short, 40. Two left, 40. Three right, 30.
Whoa. 3 tenths back though, off Cali, it's not bad. I want it to be the other way though. Hopefully more than 3 tenths, but you know what I mean.
4 left short, 80. 6 left, half long, slowing, 80. 1 right, half long, and 2 left, keep in, and 3 right.
Oh, keep it tidy.
30, 5 left, 30,
sometimes I think in these
right,
kind of rallies, five, tidy is fast.
And 3 left, and 6 right, 40. 5 left sharp, 80. Long crest, 50. Left of a jump, and 4 right, and 6 left. Into small jump, 100.
That's not the line I needed, but we'll get away with it. Left, lucky not to get a penalty as well there. Just tipped it in way too early. Oh no. Okay, we are just apparently cheating death at the moment. 4 tenths back. How close can I stay to Robin Pera without getting in front of him, apparently, now is the question. Bear in mind, we know Craig Breen and Lassie will probably go quicker.
And 6 left, Titans of a crest, and 5 left, over bump, into 5 right, half long Titans, over bridge, into 4 left of a crest,
the scenery.
70. 6 left, 6 right to the crest.
Oh, come on. Come on, just get in the road. 5
right to the crest. 5 left short, 30.
So
right.
Easy to get scrappy here.
And left of a crest, 40. 6 right, and 6 left, to 4 right. Opens long, into bump, into crest. To 5 right short, slowing, 30, turn square left.
Oh, I hate that.
70. 6 left, 50. 4 right short, over crest, 50. Long crest, 40. 6 left, 70.
2 seconds six back, man. Crest. Oh, it's how tight everyone else is, though. You know, we're so close still, but pretty much everyone that's gone before me is still running quicker. No, no. Oh, we were lucky it balanced out then, otherwise we were probably going to go in for a roll. Bank angle there was way more aggressive than it ever needed to be. Right, come on. Just be quick towards the finish. Don't hit that tree. The Robin Terra's getting greasy as well, man. Come on, come on, come on. Even if you don't beat Robin Terra on this stage, just beat some people.
Finish to 5 left to stop.
Through the final corner. Ooh, we nicked the finish line there. 3 seconds back, though, in the end. You know, it's when we need to be quicker than Hoffman and stuff. And we just simply aren't at the moment. We're matching their pace, but it's not enough.
Some absolutely on-the-edge driving has paid off for this crew as they climb the event table.
Well, yeah, it is Lappy and Craig Green just trading it at the front. But, I mean, yeah, look at that. We were just seconds off Hoffman, less than that. And it's three places in it. We did go quicker than Evans, and we also took some time out of Katsuta. So we're back up to ninth place then, but two stages to go. Thierry Neuville is our next target. But I'm not sure, unless we get a bit of a miracle, we're going to be able to get a lot more than that. The Sprigbrenner stage up next then. I probably butchered the name. But yeah, we need to be quick. Hopefully showcase we've got some pace before the Wolf Power stage. Hopefully we will have a clean car at the end of this, ready for the willpower stage as well. Picked up 4 points last time out. I reckon we could probably aim to try and do the same here. Although there has been nothing between Lappy and Craig Green all event long, so I'd be impressed if we could split them anywhere. Nice and tidy early on. This is one of the ones I don't know as well. I don't believe. We'll wait and see what happens.
Left of the crest, 100. Four left of a jump, half long, 120. Six right of a jump, 50.
Oh, that was good.
Four left short,
tidy.
50, make four right, half long.
Into crest, look at that, 18. Half second up. That's what we need more of, though.
Crest, and slight right, very long.
And if we can go quicker than Robin Perra, it means we're going quicker than pretty much everyone else that we want to try and beat.
And four left, opens long. Into six left. Cut 110. Bump. Full right sharp. And slight left. It's a bump. It's a slight right. And crest. It's a four left.
Come on.
Tightens. Don't cut.
Keep it tidy.
70. Slowing. Five right. Very long. It's a turn. Hairpin right. 60.
Still half second. Drifted into the apex. Get the power down nice and smoothly on the exit.
Right, don't cut, opens, into right of the crest, into five left, opens long, and six right, into bridge,
I think we've got quite a fast
right
bit coming
crest,
up,
42 left, and three right, half long, opens,
so 30. Difficult with the snow drifts everywhere, you just don't
Late
know where you
left,
can commit
half long,
to an early entry and where
and
you can,
right, don't cut, 40,
ooh, always forget that little bit of shrubs on the inside. Never know whether they're going to do more damage.
Four right, and five left, caution into crest, and two right, open top.
That's good though.
40.
Gap up.
Late three
just
left.
To build a little bit, although this is a very, very wide open stage, so it does give you more room just to attack. Ooh, ah, come on.
Crest, 80.
Staggering damage, just a little bit of wheel spin can slow you down.
Crest, 30, four right short of a bump, 40. Six left, don't cut, 120. Late, six left of crest, 40, four right, long, 120. Six right, 30, five left short, don't cut. Late, four right, 50. Late, three left,
still
somehow
that gap floating.
And five right, very long, break. Turn square right, unseen. And six left,
so I believe,
240.
Yeah. Now, coming up, we got a really, really fast bit of road, so hopefully going to be able to take some time.
Six left, tightens, and late six right, with a crest. To side left, 60. Left of a crest, 250.
There are still some horrible bits along here, though.
Early, six left,
catch you
crest, 60,
and ruin your
right,
rally.
Long, 50.
Like that.
Late, five right to the crest, tightens, four left short of a crest, and six right, and five left,
don't
80.
Get a penalty.
Slight left, 50, six right to the crest, long, 80, left of a crest, 70, slight left, half long, 170, crest, 70. Five left, opens, 70, four right short, over bump, 90.
Doesn't get any
right
less scary.
Crest,
oh no, how did the gap
slowly.
Come down? Oh, I nailed that.
Six right, don't cut, 80, turn, one left short, 70, slight. 20 left of the crest, 40.
Horrible braking zone down there, and then you ride the throttle again.
Crest, 100. Four on sharp of a crest and jump, 40 left of the crest, 50. Five left sharp of a crest, 80. Crest and jump to six left, opens, 80. Right of a small crest, 30, and left of a small jump, 90.
Oh, come on, no. Don't start throwing away the gap. Right, you worked crest, hard for 70. That.
Small jump, 70. Left of a bump, 50. Six right of the crest, tightens four, short of a jump, and five left, 40.
There's one right horrible corner, left, though. I know right at the end of this crest, stage.
140. Slowing, six right of the crest.
Yeah, there you go, final corner. Not wanting to attack with anything through there. As he gets up on two wheels, up over the line though. 5 seconds up. That's what we needed. Quicker than Robin Parra. Maybe quicker than Craig Breed and Lappy as well. No, not quite.
Nor down following this stage. This crew are setting a good rhythm, but may need to push a bit more to get the biggest rewards.
But almost 9 seconds up on Thierry Neuville, so that's exactly what we want with one stage to go. The gap just 0.3 of a second. Maybe, just maybe, if we can get some big points in the Wolf Power stage, we can try and get Elvin Evans as well there. 7th place with 5 power stage points, hypothetical? I'd be pretty happy with that. One more to go. We've got a bit of confidence behind us. Let's do this thing. Come on, then. We need to be about 10 seconds clear of Takamoto Katsuta at the end of this one. His time, all the other backmarkers' times, they're pretty irrelevant.
Go 40, five right,
we need to be, yeah, as long as we're in the green, that's the most important thing. After that, it's far more about how much we are in the green. A bit like Monte Carlo. We need a big result here. Come on then, Takamoto Katsuta's time, it's pretty much irrelevant. We need a big final run. Need to be up about 10 seconds on him.
Go 45 right, opens.
But yeah, this is not going to be easy. A bit like Monte Carlo, we've kind of got to just go for it. That's not the way to start. Come on. We can't immediately make a mistake like that. We've got to keep going. There is a huge opportunity here. We know there is. There is pace in this car still. So we get towards the end of this rally. Come on, we know this stage. We know we can be quick here.
Three left of the crest, half long, tightens, 70. Make four right, 90.
Come on, get off those
three left short,
snow drifts 40, and everything.
Six left of the crest, 30. Five right of the crest, 60. Slight left and six right short, 60. Crest and crest, 30. Three left short. Crest, 40, 5 right, slowing,
we're up on Taka, but not by much.
Right, and bump, 30, 6 left, opens of a crest.
Come on, that's really slow.
Into dip, to 4 left of a jump, opens, and 5 left, to 5 right of the jump, don't cut, 40, 6 left, 50, crest, 30, 4 left of the crest, and 5 right, 5 left of a crest, keep in, into 6 right, to slight left, to 5 right, short of
come
crest,
on.
40, up. Right,
be so careful of these banks. And that.
To five right,
that was horrible.
Bumps, 40. Six left, break, 60. Two right sharp, at junction, at crest.
Always makes me laugh.
Left,
it's a two this way and a one the other way. And it feels tighter going through it that way around.
Right, cut, and two left,
I think I've had a little bit of a safety buffer though over Taka, which is good. We've got to keep pushing.
Into crest,
we cannot afford just to relax now. We wanna, well, we can't afford to lose to him either.
Of
course, there's not much time
right
between us overall. 5 seconds up, though. I said we needed 10 seconds by the end, so we're getting
right
pretty
crest,
good on eye for that.
Right of a jump, 40,
we've got to keep going.
Left of a bump and right of a
where are we going
jump,
that way?
50, crest, 70. Four right short, into six left, break, 30. Three right and four left, opens. 50.
Come on.
Five right.
Really trying to avoid letting the car slide
left
around too much.
Tightens three of a crest and two right. to one left.
Just want
keep
to keep it tidy.
60. Six right.
Put on a good show for the fans, 40. Nonetheless.
Rest, 40. Five right short. Up, five left. 40. Four right. 40.
Oh, no. No.
30.
No penalty, four somehow. Left. Well, that was immediately going to be a 5 second one then.
Right,
I got away with it.
40, five short,
never quite know what the rules are here in Sweden, but come on, one more split to go. We are 10 seconds up on Katsuta. This is fantastic. Just got to bring it home. Still got the big jump though to come. There it is.
Oh,
it never gets any less scary.
70. Slight left, Titans 3, short,
come on.
30, slight
come on.
Right, opens,
I'd love some power stage points.
80, 4 left, Titans 2, around bales, to right of a crest, 40, bump, 6 right
that's
to
good.
Crest, extra long, keep in,
quick
60,
but committed.
4 left, keep in, 40, 5 right,
it will still go wrong though, right until the very end, as I've found out many
opens,
times before on this game.
And slight right. 30,
one more real corner to go, though, I think.
And bridge, 30, turn, square right.
Don't spin that. So easy
left,
to do.
Over finish, into five right,
oh,
to
we
stop.
Just about got the hybrid as well on the exit, and that's going to be a 4:12, which I believe was a very, very competitive time on stage one. Hello, marshals. Show me what I want to see. Come on. No idea why the wing is vibrating as much as it is. But we've also, as you can clearly see, got the snowplow modification on the front of the car.
Very nicely driven through that stage. It's a great result for the crew who, as a result, have moved up in the event standings.
Well, there we go then. 5 Wolf Power stage points this time out there. So we do one better than we did in Monte Carlo as well. There, and Seb Ogier, championship leader, not getting a Wolf Power stage point as well. So that helps us out if we are going to be in the title fight come the end of the season. But 9 seconds clear of Neuville and Hoffman as well. 10 seconds clear of Elvin Evans. Have we maybe jumped anyone else by the end of this rally? I'm not convinced we have. Oh, we did jump Evans in the end. Fantastic news then. So P7 there. Plus, obviously, so 6 points for that, plus the 5 for the Wolf Power stage, means we actually outscore Seb Ogier this time out there. We only lose out points to our top 4, so we're pretty happy with that. Let's take a look what that means for the championship. That's good. We're still ahead of M Sport 4. That's really important as well. And overall, then, in the standings, we are up to 7th place, then 2 points ahead of my teammate Hoffman. Still 2 points back behind Elvin Evans there, as Seb Ogier still leads the way, 3 ahead of Cali Rovanperä. But I believe, I want to say the next round might be Croatia. I think we might have one more before we head to Rally Croatia, but that is going to be a lot of fun. And well, happy that we're picking up some good points early on this season as well there. Thank you all so much for watching. If you have enjoyed, please do make sure to leave a like, get yourself subscribed. And yeah, we'll be back very soon with more EA WRC content.